Employees of McDonald's, what secrets did you discover while working there? Former employee here, I found out that, when making 5 gallons of sweet tea, an entire 4-pound bag of sugar goes in. Sandwiches with round egg use real, cracked eggs. Folded and scrambled come from packaged goods in the freezer or fridge. I also had a manager that insisted more people purchase Filet-O-Fish when it's raining out because they subconsciously associate the watery weather with fish. Anyway, he did some research by pouring through sales of Filet-O-Fish for months and months and comparing it to weather data for each day. Turns out he found something like a 3% increase on rainy days and was very pleased with himself. Edit. Wow. I will answer some of your questions up here so people can see. The manager voiced his theory one day, and the crews all argued with him about it. This went on for a while. He was committed to proving us wrong, so he secretly pulled the sales numbers at work and did the rest on his own time, never breathing a word until he brought his printed report in to shut us all up. He did separate Fridays during Lent and compared those days to each other in anticipation of having holes poked in his research. We still did that anyway, of course. As pointless and imperfect as the research was, it was impressive to see his commitment to giving us the middle finger. I absolutely love that guy's commitment. Dehydrated onions, you put them in a metal thing and just add water, the thing is they still taste great. But I was shocked and happy that I didn't have to go cut onions. Did they taste good just dehydrated? The official deodorizing spray they gave us is the most pleasant thing I've ever smelled in my entire life. Even now, I wish I could smell it again. For the one I worked at in high school, burgers are kept in a warming area for no more than 15 minutes, then thrown out and new ones are made. You get a free meal from anything except the salads. Meal is a sandwich, medium fries and a medium drink. At the end of the night, all the cooked meat is thrown out. If you want, you can use it to make burgers and take them home with you. Specific tools and grill section for cooking chicken versus beef to make sure they don't cross for those customers who don't eat beef. The Hindu co-workers were very vocal about this rule if you worked the grill. Regarding the free meal, I remember it was a free meal every 4 hours. Ultimately, you could have 2 free meals during an 8-hour shift. My manager used to be on my back all of the time for giving out too much sauce. He tried telling me the limit is 1 per meal. Our store did 1 sauce for 4 and 6 piece nuggets, 2 for 10 and 3 for 20. I worked there when I was in high school. Not a secret, but I hadn't known much about franchises before then. I hadn't realized that McDonald's could vary quite a bit in quality and professionalism based on who the owners were and what type of management, workplace they set up. I worked at a really good one, with good management, I mean, but some are shit. Even as someone who is a customer, not a McDonald's worker, this has always been pretty clear to me. I remember being told before doing international travel that McDonald's is usually a safe bet as somewhere that will have a clear toilet while you're out exploring. That's pretty accurate based on my experience in UK, Europe, North Africa. But I've also been to the McDonald's at Logan Central in Brisbane, Australia, and it was the single most disgustingly unclean restaurant I've ever been to, bar none. A toilet with no seat and toilet paper strewn about the room. Tables that hadn't been cleaned in hours, and staff that looked at me like I had 2 heads when I politely asked if they could wipe the table down for us. Seriously, I don't expect Michelin stars when I go to McDonald's, but that place would have been closed down immediately if any sort of health inspector visited. I learned that if I have time to lean, I have time to clean. Got time to text, got time to Windex. The pickles are surprisingly aerodynamic. They stick to walls and, if you have the stones, manager's shirts pretty well. Yeah, they fly amazing. Pretty sure me and my old crew cost that store about $1,000 the entire time we worked there just throwing them things. Lol. If you want a good replacement Big Mac sauce, 3 big tablespoons of good quality mayo. About a single good tablespoon of ketchup. 2 teaspoons of gherkin relish. 1 tablespoon or so of pickle juice, 1 teaspoon of garlic powder. 1/2 to 1 teaspoon of turmeric. Mix till thoroughly combined. Leave in the fridge to let the ingredients make friends with one another overnight. Edit. I looked it up, and apparently this is just my version of fucking Thousand Island dressing. Do you mean 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric? I've been cooking a long time and it seems way off to me. It's just so overpowering. Not trying to be an asshole. Man, reading these I am wondering why my McDonald's was so boring. We didn't spit on anything. The stuff that needed to be kept clean was kept clean. If it wasn't required it would be filthy. The ice cream machine worked fine. Food wasn't undercooked, on occasion it was overcooked. Employing high school kids, of course they are gonna make some mistakes, but nothing too bad. I worked at McDonald's when they first introduced sweet tea and remember that it was brewed in a large bucket mixing hot water with a full bag of granulated sugar. It makes me sick to think about, but I still sometimes crave that disgustingly sweet tasty garbage. Somebody elsewhere in the thread mentioned it's 4 pounds per 5 gallons. My old McDonald's had a basement. E-I-E-I-O. Worked there in high school. Found out that if you put the middle of a Mac bun in the fryer and then add soft serve and strawberry topping, it tastes just like a funnel cake. Custom creations were the best part of working there. Cheeseburger bun fried, add the chai latte powder, cinnamon donut. Drop any unopened chicken nugget sauce on the ground once, you've got yourself a sauce grenade. Trash compactor can make for some fun explosions too. We had a Vol-pack of ketchup that needed tossed for whatever reason. Someone didn't realize it shouldn't go into the compactor. I go back after hearing a bang and a scream. Dude is just caked in ketchup and it shot up out of the barrel of the manual compactor and painted the wall, ceiling, and bun rack. They have since taken away the Vol-packs. I started working at Mcd's when I was 15. The secret is that it's probably one of the cleanest restaurants in your city. The standardizations and routine practices leave little room for employees to think for themselves. It was a way cleaner restaurant than the $30-$50 per person place I would work at later. Exactly. I worked at McDonald's 10 years ago and eventually went to work at a high-end restaurant in a fancy part of my city. I'm still amazed at how clean my McDonald's was compared to the fancy restaurant. My first day on the job, I was told to be on the lookout for the elderly gentleman who would try to sneak around the counter and pour the entire coffee pot into his mug while everyone was too busy to stop him. Did you ever catch him in the act? The Big Mac is just a double cheeseburger with 1000 island dressing, lettuce and an extra piece of bread. If you order a double, add lettuce and Big Mac sauce, you get the same thing with less bread and cheaper price. Depending on which one you work at, the parking lot is basically a meetup for druggies, drug dealers and, at least where I was in New Mexico, people to meet up and have sex in their cars. As long as they kept their business to the middle of the night and didn't cause any serious problems, we were told not to call the cops or make a fuss, mostly because they'd come in and buy food after their shenanigans. Soda and mini pies were really popular with heroin addicts. What I later found out is that management was actually told to let it slide by corporate, since everyone higher up was aware of how much money that night crowd brought in. I got to see many, many drug deals. I'm convinced I saw at least one arms deal, but I of course have no way of verifying that. Midnight shifts were draining but so much fun. The kitchen staff is cut by half, but the people who order are so funny. A couple of Mormon missionary guys came in one time and ordered their food, and also ordered French fries with no salt. So the fries had to be fried specially, with no salt. They told me it was their tactic to get hot fries. I always thought it was hilarious how people would think they'd be so smart by ordering fries with no salt when you could literally just ask for fresh fries. Worked in one from 2000 to 2005. During this time, they changed the bacon. The new bacon isn't as good. During this time, they changed the shake mix. The new shake mix isn't as good. The shake machine works just fine, so long as someone remembers to fill it before it gets too empty and goes into automatic 90-minute self-clean mode. It also takes a very long time to start up, so if someone forgets, there's no shakes for 30 minutes. This was never a problem for me. Whenever I did opening shift, I'd kick off the coffee brewing for my team, then start up the shake machine for myself. The chocolate chip cookies and McGriddles taste amazing if you eat fresh out of the oven. Always made an extra half tray for myself. If you're ordering a meal, say the size first, large number one with a Coke. Everyone knows that ordering the meal is cheaper than getting that same sandwich, fries, and drink individually, but here's the secret. The POS has a button for the large number one and a different button for the medium number one, then another menu for the drinks. So if you say, I want a number one with a Coke, I can't hit any buttons until I know the sizes of the meal, the size of the fries, and the size of the drink. The newer POS systems make your last point a bit easier, where you can click, make meal, and change the size there. Before I worked there, I always thought they used a grill. Turns it's more of a heated press machine. Used to be a grill. Upgrades. There is a glitch with the McDonald's app. There is a deals section and it usually has a coupon for a free cookie or free apple pie with any order. Add it to your order and you get the free cookie. Then, the next time you order from the app, just reorder your last meal. You can add, subtract whatever you want, but the free cookie will still be there. The glitch is that you can add another free cookie from the deals section, and now you have two free cookies. Evidently there is no cap to this. I now get 5 free cookies with each order. I stopped at 5 because I felt that any more than that would be overkill. Anyone who says they messed with food was lying, unless it's something boring like, we left patties in the warmers too long. One thing I was shocked by, this was pre-internet forums being widely used, so it was just info from people working there, was that no burgers are flipped. You put your 10-to-1 patties or 4-to-1 patties on the grill and hit a couple buttons and a second grill comes down and both sides are cooked for you. I loved scooping a big tower of them off the grill to plop into the warming trays. Also, I worked in one in the desert and sometimes our AC would crap out, but only for the back. So you'd be sweating over the stupid grill and your co-workers would be hiding in the freezer. Asterisk, it's a fucked up mess of cogs and gear that still has some fucked way of working. Asterisk. Ex-worker of a McDonald's. Greater than, it's a fucked up mess of cogs and gear that still has some fucked way of working. Employees of every company, it's easy to hold the view of an organization as super competent and well-run when you don't have to deal with its shit 40 hours a week. Anyone claiming the employees do disgusting stuff with food is lying. The kitchens are not only open and completely visible to customers, but also heavily monitored by camera. If someone was messing with the food, you can bet they would be fired and escorted out before they even finished whatever deed they were committing. Look, it's fine to not like McDonald's. It's fine to think it's gross. It's fine if you just hate fast food, logical, even. But making things up to disgust people is not okay. Source. Former McDonald's corporate employee, worked in both corporate and franchised locations. Standards and practices are normalized and enforced in both. If you do notice things like the people in this topic are claiming, report it to management or report the location to McDonald's customer service. I remember I went into this one McDonald's that I go to regularly since it was on my way back from work. One time I went in and I'm not joking when I say models were taking orders and it looked like they might have even brought in an actual chef to make the food. I had no idea what to think of the situation until I realized there was a woman in a business suit and clipboard was asking the franchisee a lot of specific questions. They must take these visits from corporate seriously if this one went to pretty extreme lengths when they came around. All drinks come in as a syrup and are carbonated on the spot, hence why it can taste flat sometimes. There used to be a way to get a discount code for every second that the timer was running on a coupon, but they patched that in 2017. The ice cream machine at my place usually broke down because people mixed up the milkshake bags with blue caps and the ice cream bags with red caps while filling the machine. Mismanagement is surprisingly common and corporate doesn't give a single shit as long as there is sufficient profit coming in. Greater than the ice cream machine at my place usually broke down greater than because people mixed up the milkshake bags with blue greater than caps and the ice cream bags with red caps while filling the greater than machine. Worked at a Chick-fil-A years ago and someone mixed up the coleslaw dressing with the ice cream mix. Was disgusting to clean. Nothing much honestly. I worked there for over a year. Everything is cleaned properly, no one messes with food, because there's always a manager nearby. The food is rather fresh, etc. While a lot of the stuff is frozen, that doesn't make it bad. Only thing is, the tea is very easy to screw up. It's easy to accidentally leave the spout open and have tea covering the floor. Once we had a bag of coffee break and it got into the ice, and into the tea and we didn't realize right away, so some people got some coffee in their tea. When it comes to allergies though, everyone I worked with was very diligent. If someone had a bad allergy to, like, bread, we would remove our gloves, wash our hands, arms, put on new gloves and make sure that the item was okay. Given, that was probably the case because we didn't want a lawsuit. Another secret is how much food McDonald's wastes. We had a bucket to toss the food in, and managers had to count it at the end of the day. It was disgusting to see how much, perfectly edible, food was being thrown out. Luckily, if your manager is cool, you could ask to eat it in the back quickly. This was especially the case with pies. Frankly, the company was fine. They offered to give you scholarships, pay for you to get your diploma if you didn't have one, always paid above minimum wage, though sometimes barely, and it was easy to get a promotion if you asked and put in the work. That being said, I still hate corporations, and the franchise owners were assholes who ignored a bunch of stuff. Customers threw their food at me if something was wrong, i.e. not enough salt, and I had minor burns from it. I was told I was a massive cunt and should KMS. List goes on. Oh, also, you're not allowed to take tips.
Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.